since the mid-1970s, skiing for the disabled has played an important part in the winter sports season. Hello everybody, I'm Ian Sweet and welcome to Lech in Austria for the fifth Disabled Alpine Ski Championship. And well, we've got 1.33 kilometers in length. Stacy Kohut, the Canadian, the LW12 category. And he's been on the national team, the Canadian national team, for some 3 years. And again, we've got a combined categories of 10, 11s and 12s. In disabled parlance, Stacy is skiing in the odds and sods category. It's the one that are difficult to categorize together, but he's competing against the other disabilities with primarily lower limbs, sitski, gold medal for Kohut. And not a bad performance by him. In the 94 Olympics, he won his first in the Super-G and fourth in the slalom. Welcome back to Lech in Austria for the fifth Disabled Alpine Ski Championships, and it's race day two, the Super-G, the Austrian. Now moving on to the Canadian, Stacy Kohut. He's already picked up the gold medal in the downhill, and he's looking for the double here. This is the Super-G LW12 category. He's in the combined LW12 and 11s. Because there aren't eight skiers in his category, and like the downhill, it's another go for him. 1.684 for Stacy Kohut, the Canadian. Good performance by him, so that's two in the bag for him. And
when you're an athlete, you have three things to worry about. Number one, getting up in the morning. Number two, where you're going. Number three, the one thought and the one goal that you have for the day, you know, of going down the course.
The man that's prepared the most is the man that's going to win.
I think disabled sports, especially skiing, with the speed involved, are as intense, if not more intense, than 90% of the sports out there today.
I really enjoy that and enjoy pushing myself to be the best and to be more prepared than the next guy.
Und auf der Strecke, John Davies mit der Nummer 66.
Take a look at what's going on around here. Most of these people have overcome so many things just to get into the vault and skiing. Then you add ski racing on top of that, you add international ski racing on top of that. I think this is one of the most intense things I've ever done, and I've done a lot of intense things.
I think that skiers, mono skiers today, at least the top mono skiers, have definitely surpassed technology.
John is a natural competitor.
Go!
There's more depth, there are more countries that are getting competitive, and that's good. I think that's really good for the sport.
From the United States of America, 1.41.15.